Hi everyone, welcome to today's Chamber Chat. Thank you so much for tuning in today. I did want to give a quick reminder that tomorrow morning in this exact boardroom,
right here,
we have Get to Know Your Chamber. So if you have any questions about what we go over today, you're more than welcome to reach out to us via phone or email. But tomorrow morning is Get to Know Your Chamber here at the Chamber at 8 a.m. It's complimentary for current members, future members, and we really hope you can join us there to learn a little bit more about the Chamber.
And come have breakfast with us, too. It's also sponsored by Mickey Fine,
Mickey
one of our
Fine.
Members. So
exactly.
Definitely come hang out with us tomorrow morning.
Delicious breakfast, delicious coffee, and great people.
Absolutely.
So that's tomorrow morning here at 8 a.m. Get to Know Your Chamber. All the things that we're going to be going over today are going to be commented below. So if you have any questions about it, just see the comments in a few minutes. But we'll get started here. My name is Alexandria Anderson. I'm the Director of Marketing and Events for the Chamber.
I am Michelle Green. I'm the Director of Membership for the Chamber.
Perfect. So. And again, we thank you all for joining us today with today's Chamber Chat on why Beverly Hills Chamber. Kind of a broad brush stroke on all the things that we offer and really what we're all about. So what we're all about, our mission. Our mission is to empower businesses to thrive by being an invaluable resource for optimizing connections. Everything we do revolves around that mission. That is our mission, but let's back it up just a little bit. Michelle, tell us a little bit of background about the Chamber. Like, what is the Chamber even?
Absolutely. It's funny with even some of our new members that join, they're surprised to see everything that the Chamber does do. But primarily, we're a membership organization for businesses in the community. You also, fact, do not have to have your business in Beverly Hills to join. But if you're wanting to connect with the business community in Beverly Hills, then it makes sense to join. But the Chamber has been around for nearly 100 years. We're, what, at 98?
Yes, we just celebrated 98. We have our 98th chairperson right now, Deborah Kallick, that we inducted at Summer Garden Party.
Very, very excited. Mm-hmm. So, to have an organization that's been around that long to really help the businesses in the community, help the economic development in the community, our role is to help businesses be successful. Because if they're successful, they're going to stay around, and that's just better for the city as a whole.
Exactly.
The connections that people make by joining the Chamber can help not only, you socially, but definitely business-wise. Mm-hmm. I'm a testament to the Chamber myself. I moved to L.A. 4 years ago, did not know a soul in Los Angeles at all, let alone Beverly Hills.
Where'd you move from?
South Carolina.
Oh.
Hilton Head Island.
Love that.
Miss you guys. But to move into a city and not know anyone at all, I knew by my past experience, joining a chamber was the best way to get to know as many people as quickly as possible. And so I purposefully looked for a job with a chamber for that very reason. And lo and behold, I personally did not even know that Beverly Hills had a chamber.
Yeah.
So I think that was the biggest surprise for me, and a very pleasant surprise. But not only is it a chamber, it's a family here. The staff is amazing. Our ambassadors are amazing. But to be part of a chamber that is really concerned about your well-being and wanting to help you succeed in whatever facet it may be with your business, that's really ultimately what we're here to do.
Absolutely. So that's a little bit of chamber background, a little bit of Michelle background. We talked about our mission. Our chamber actually has some core values.
Yes.
So we have six of them. Do you want to give us an idea of the first three of those?
Absolutely. So the first one is create connections and build strong relationships. And I think that being number one is our priority. Obviously, it's the mission of the chamber. And so we're always looking to connect people. And that's my passion and forte. That's my favorite part of my job, is making those connections for businesses in the community.
She has a nickname with us. She's our membership matchmaker.
I love that. And for a girl that moved here, 4 years ago, not knowing anybody, that tells you what the chamber can do for you. So that's exciting. But encourage teamwork and collaboration. That's, when we talk about these core values, it's not just the core values for our members. It's also core values for our staff. It's core values for our board, our ambassadors.
Exactly.
We really, truly live by these core values. And that teamwork and collaboration is so important and so vital, not just as a staff here, which, by the way, we're staff of 10, but to produce over 200 events and programs a year with a staff of 10, you have to have teamwork and collaboration.
Exactly.
So, but it's also further than that. It's the teamwork and collaboration among our members. And that's also something that I strive to really promote, you know, having members co-host events together or,
absolutely,
you know, partner in on different aspects with their businesses. That's huge and vital. The next one is never satisfied and always improving. That's just a core value in myself personally, always striving to be better.
Oh, yeah.
But I think as a chamber, that's vital. You know, you never want to become complacent. You always want to keep, you know, raising the bar, which I think this young lady here has done an amazing job overseeing
you.
Our marketing and our events. Those of you that have attended our events know that with Alex, but just, you know, always seeking to improve.
Absolutely. So those final three core values, commitment to excellence, a little bit similar to that, never satisfied, always improving, but we are committed to the excellence within our what we provide our members. Hospitality is huge for us.
Yeah.
If you've been to any of our events, you've probably heard Todd say, we want to make sure everyone who attends our events leave them feeling better than when they came.
Absolutely.
So we have a commitment to excellence with that. The fifth core value, understanding the value of a reputation. Beverly Hills is a brand known throughout the entire globe, one of the strongest brand names that we have. So we need to understand the value of that reputation and what that holds within the community, greater LA area.
Absolutely.
The globe.
We're very blessed, actually, to have that brand name.
Actually, yes. And then the sixth and final core value, our favorite,
have fun.
So like Michelle said, we have our staff that we make sure that the staff are following these six core values, our board, our ambassadors, and there's a trickle down effect within our membership as well. We strive to hold them very dear to us. So that's a little bit of a background on the core values, but going back again, I'm going to say the mission over and over, guys. Maybe you'll get sick of hearing it. But we empower
that's
businesses to thrive by being an invaluable resource for optimizing connections. So how do we create those platforms for our members to form those connections? Because it's really all about who you know.
It absolutely is.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that may sound very cliche, but ultimately it is. And all, you know, it's all in who you know for your business. But as far as the chamber is concerned, the three main ways are government affairs and advocacy, events and programs, and marketing and sponsorship.
Okay. So those are the three main ways that we really strive to create platforms for a member to form these connections.
Yes.
So they can empower their business to thrive.
So
the first one was government affairs and advocacy. We do have a chamber chat on this with Blair and I. So Michelle's going to give you a bit of an idea on that, but if you do want further information, see that chamber chat. But again, tell us more about government affairs and advocacy, because it's a little bit of an ambiguous term if you're not too familiar with it.
Right. You know, I would say first and foremost, the advocacy piece of it, if your business is within the city of Beverly Hills, don't wait until your business opens to join the chamber, because there's so much of the background that we can help you with from day one. So if you're getting a business license in Beverly Hills, get your business license and join the chamber, because throughout your process, whether it's a permitting issue or, you know, whatever bump in the road that you may come across, we're here to help. We can be that one-stop call for you.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't know who to connect with, or if you don't know how to resolve an issue, you know, we're certainly going to be able to, if we can't resolve it for you, we will be able to connect you to the person who can. And that's really what we're here. So time is money, you know, when you're opening a business. And when, you know, people think, oh, I'll join the chamber when my business opens for my, you know, grand opening and my ribbon cutting and to promote, you know, once it's open, that's wonderful. And we're here and wanting to help with that aspect of it. But there's so much more behind the scenes.
Absolutely.
On that advocacy side. And then the the chamber is the voice of the businesses in the community. So being part of the business community here, it's important to stay, you know, on top of the issues that are happening that will impact your business. Not every issue may impact it, but there's going to be something along the line that will.
Yeah.
So in the past, we've helped businesses when we had the Santa Monica reconstruction. We've got the Metro line coming through,
yes,
you know, which is going to be great for the city, but it does have some impact on some of the local businesses here.
Absolutely.
And so the chamber is at the forefront of helping those businesses protect themselves and to make sure that, you know, the impact, we can, you know, help mitigate the impact as much as possible on that. And then we also, you know, can take it up a step with the advocacy piece as far, mm-hmm, as enhanced advocacy.
Yeah.
If you are a larger business, if you're, you know, wanting to have a project or some sort of development within the community and you're looking for support from city council, come to the chamber. We're here to help, you know, garner some of that support for you. But the being the voice of the businesses in the community, I think this is a good to mention that we are separate from the city. While we have an amazing connection and partnership with the city, we are a separate entity. So, mm-hmm, we can really be that voice of businesses where the residential community can, you know, vote on some of the legislative issues that are coming down,
yeah,
the pipeline. They do impact the business community, and the way to have your business's voice heard is by being a member of the chamber. Come to our government affairs committee,
yeah,
meetings. They're the
second
Thursday of every month.
Mm-hmm.
So as a member, you're more than welcome to attend those meetings. They're complimentary, and that's where you get to vote, you know,
yeah,
and that's where your voice is heard. And so once we gather up the biggest voice of the community in the business world here, we take it to City Hall and we fight for the businesses. So that's important.
Absolutely. So that would be next Thursday, actually.
Mm-hmm.
So August 8th, we do have the next Government Affairs Committee meeting. So if you are a member, you're more than welcome to attend that. It's been a full house the past several,
yeah,
months. So there are a lot of things coming down the pipeline, not only with the city, but also with the state as well. So Blair Schlechter, our Vice President of Economic Development and Government Affairs, he works side by side with our legislators, the city, on lots of these different topics to, as Michelle said, make sure that the business community voice is heard.
Absolutely.
So that was a really good, I guess you could say, broad brush stroke of government affairs and advocacy.
Yeah.
Was there something else you wanted to add on?
Well,
that?
Well, to tag,
yeah,
on to what,
totally,
you were saying,
yeah,
is, you know, some of the legislative issues that you don't really think of or maybe not even be aware of. You know,
yeah,
Beverly Hills has become a non-smoking city. And so there was, you know, the legislative vote that came down for banning smoking or banning the sale of tobacco products, or,
mm-hmm,
you know, currently they're doing the legislative procedure on the ban of the sale of alligator or fur. And so depending, you know, you can be on either side of it, but it is an issue. And so that's where, you know, coming to the chamber and learning
staying
the facts,
informed.
Staying informed.
Mm-hmm.
And if it does impact your business, you absolutely should be part of the chamber to make sure that you're on top of those things.
Absolutely. No, thank you. And
yeah,
thank you for adding that. So three main ways. One, government affairs advocacy. Two, events and programs. Three, marketing and sponsorship. Let's go into the events and programs,
yeah,
shall we?
Yeah.
So, as Michelle said earlier, and as we say on almost every chamber chat, we produce over 200 events and programs per year. Each of the events, of course, serve a different purpose, because there's different tiers of people that are coming to those, different amounts of people that we have at each of them, different venues, different collaborations that happen with each. So give us a broad brushstroke on our events and how they serve as, of course, a platform for connections.
Absolutely. So as Alex mentioned, we have a tiered due structure, you know, to our membership packages, and they're really broken down into two categories. We have our small business packages, which I know that you guys have covered.
A little bit, yes.
And we'll talk, we can probably break that down even more.
Yeah.
But the small business packages have access to the events and programs that are considered our regular networking,
okay,
events. And so, you know, those would be the educational seminars, the networking breakfast, the flair mixer that,
yeah,
we had last night that,
yes,
was absolutely successful.
Thanks, Ocean Prime.
Yes, thank you very much. So there are such a wide array of events that the small business packages have access to. But then the other category is for our what we call Chairman Circle members. Those are the upper level members of the chamber. They invest a little bit more in the chamber. Primarily, you'll see higher level managers, decision makers, CEOs of the company. They tend to not have a whole lot of time to do some networking. And so to help them stay connected, we create this private invite-only network for them. So they know by coming to, say, these exclusive receptions or experiences that we have for them, or even the high-level networking luncheon that we do on a monthly basis, it's about getting the right people in the right room at the right time for them.
And so it's really those two kind of tiers of networking opportunities that we have. So it's the regular networking opportunities and education, and then the more curated, I guess you could say, networking opportunities and audiences.
Exactly. And that's really where it comes down to who it is you want to connect with.
Okay.
So those two different packages, it's based on size of your business, what marketing value you'd like to bundle in your, you know, package.
Yes.
And then also who you want to connect with.
Okay.
So that's really, and with those, the Chairman Circle events, we've had some amazing events. Recently, we just had Louis Vuitton X, the exhibit here on the corner of Rodeo Drive.
Yes, just that way.
In Santa Monica. It is open to the public, so if you have not been, I believe it's September 15th.
They're complimentary.
It is complimentary to go. However, as a Chairman Circle member, our members had the opportunity to have it closed down and have a private tour. We were handled at the, you know, the most epic way with Louis Vuitton, with champagne in the morning, with breakfast, past tray hors d'oeuvres. It was amazing. So, but it was more about the people in the room. You know, when you have our board members of the chamber, which, by the way, we have one of the most active board members, board of directors of the chamber that I've ever really been involved with any organization. So shout out to them. Thank you for all your help. But to be able to connect with them on a social level and interact with them in a, you know, a reception style where it's not a forced networking event. But you get to know each other more on a personal level. And that's always my that's my recommendation, is to, when you're connecting within this community, it's a relationship oriented community. So always network. That's my network tip. 101
networking tip of the day is, you always say, lead with your personal.
Absolutely.
So lead with your person and find the common ground, because that's how people are going to remember you. Like Todd says, it's all about like emotion, how people feel. So
when you come to an event, you know, say our Flair network that can have upwards of 150 attendees, you know, don't make it your mission to walk out with 150 business cards. You know, really get to know a few people and connect with them on that personal level. Business will follow, you know, and then they will eventually open up their network to you, and it'll go from there.
It'll blossom. So you talked about the Louis Vuitton X. What are some of the other venues that we've had or experiences that we've had?
I would be totally remiss without mentioning our Lunar New Year event. That's one of the signature events that Alex oversees, but it is also our annual appreciation for Chairman Circle members. So it is the largest one out of the 10 to 12 receptions that we do host for our Chairman Circle members.
It's about 400.
If not more.
It
is on a Friday night, so it tells you a little bit about what kind of party it is. It's the only one that we do on a Friday night, so that it's a great event. But it has been hosted graciously by Rolls-Royce for the last several years. O'Gara Coach is a huge platinum sponsor. You know, we really appreciate their generosity and support of the chamber, but this event is just over the top. They Rolls-Royce actually commissioned three new vehicles to be unveiled at our event using our logo. It was Year of the Pig. We actually had little piggies at the event. Very cool. But they embedded the logo into the leather seats of the car and the pinstriping and unveiled them at the event. So that just really shows you the caliber of the event, the high level.
And,
you know, McLaren all got involved as well, bringing in a Cabin McLaren along with the artist that painted it and designed it. So
it was quite the experience. And so some of them are a little bit more over the top like that, and can be more of those experiences. And then others are more of that networking reception style, where it's great to see those familiar faces and get to know everyone. On
Peterson Automotive Museum hosted one for us. Haykoff art gallery hosted mm-hmm. one for us. So it can range anywhere from a small gathering. We actually have an experience coming up at the Getty. It's a private tour by Quick Culture, one of our members, mm-hmm. you know, giving our chairman circle a private tour of the Getty Museum. So it's those experiences that you normally wouldn't be able to have on your own. And that's what Perfect. We offer our chairman circle members.
Excellent. So we're talking about like those curated audiences, more of those curated events and audiences that we put on. So one of them is the chairman circle. I don't know if we've talked much in chamber chats about the Economic Development Council, but let's get into that a little bit.
That's one of my favorites. I think, you know, what I love to say, you know, to define EDC, it's a group of elite businessmen and women in the community, along with city officials, that meet once a month for lunch at Spago. It is a separate membership outside of your membership with the chamber, but you can join it, you know, whatever level you may be as a member of the chamber, you can add that on, or it's included at some of the higher levels. But it really is an opportunity to garner relationships with those elite businessmen and women in the community and city officials. I always say it is a group of the who's in the know before anyone else knows. So if you think about, they have a speaker series that comes in once a month, amazing topics. We've had, you know, the 2028 Olympics coming in. So years before it ever even happens, you're in a room of the people that really know what's going to happen. Absolutely. And how is that going to impact our community? And that's, you know, it's a great way to find out what's coming down the pipeline. So you'll see a lot of developers, commercial real estate, investors, again, the city officials being part of it. But it's also about, you know, not necessarily just the speaker, but it's also who's in the room.
Absolutely.
You know, mm-hmm. and really fostering those relationships month after month, because again, and we can't say it enough, it's all in who you know.
Yeah.
And so it's definitely an opportunity to get to know them. But we've also had the expansion of LAX there, the Rams new stadium coming in. And coming up, we have Stan Kasten, the president and CEO of the Dodgers, on August 8th. When do you ever have a chance to have lunch with Stan Kasten?
Right? No, so that's next week. I can't believe it. It's going to be a really good time. And again, that's the Economic Development Council.
Yeah.
There's about 60 people, would you say, in the group?
Yeah. Okay. And with your membership, you get two tickets. So, and what's also nice about that, you know, oftentimes people say, I don't know if I'll be able to come and use the tickets every month, so I'm not sure about it. The great thing about them is that they're transferable. So if you aren't able to make it, they're a great option to give a client or to a colleague you know, that you work with that that can take advantage of that information and bring it back to you.
Perfect. Yeah. So that's this the EDC. It's on that monthly basis. I don't know if we mentioned where it's normally held.
Oh my gosh, I didn't say that. I'm so sorry, because it's two tickets for lunch at Spago every month. So not a bad place.
That's amazing. So
thanks, Spago.
Yes, thank you, Spago, for that. So that is a little bit about the events and programs. So we have the ongoing regular networking events and programs, along with the educational seminars and opportunities. We have the more curated audiences and curated events and people in the room, such as the Chairman Circle events and the EDC. And then, of course, we started with government affairs and advocacy. Finally, to wrap, would be marketing and sponsorship. This is really where you can take your brand awareness to the next level with the chamber. So tell us a little bit more about that.
Well, I would say, first off, every single thing that the chamber does has a sponsorship opportunity to it.
Okay.
So whether you're a small business or you're a corporation, if you look on our calendar of events, you know, 200 plus that we do produce, there's something for everyone. So if you want to sponsor a networking breakfast, you can have a captive audience of 85 to 100 attendees, you know, for $250, you can be a sponsor. Your logo will be branded on the invite. You'll have an opportunity for extra speaking time. You can have a presence there with your, you know, materials on a table.
Exhibitor booth.
Absolutely.
The registration page, which gets thousands of views throughout the month and throughout the year.
So for $250, that's an amazing opportunity for a small business to take advantage of. And then we go all the way up to sponsorship for our extravagant signature events that Alex oversees and has done such an incredible job raising the bar on those. You know, to have the corporations and the larger businesses be, you know, presenting sponsors of our events, they're absolutely reasonable, you know, to garner the attention of our audiences of upwards of 700 people. We just had at our summer garden party. So when you have the biggest networking event in Beverly Hills, 700 business men and women in the community all gathered at one time, and being a presenting sponsor at that event, it's a great opportunity, and we do about 7 of those signature events throughout the year. So that's
a really great opportunity then too.
Okay. And then we also have tremendous reach with our marketing opportunities. So again, that's under Alex's area of expertise, and as she does a phenomenal job, and look for our Monday morning e-blasts that come from the chamber that tell you. it's clockwork. You can set your clock by it. I love it. That Monday morning has a reach of 11,000 plus subscribers.
11,500.
Oh, yeah. See? and to be able to have a newsletter spotlight on there and reach those 11,500 subscribers, that's a huge opportunity, and that's available to our members. You can also do your own separate e-blasts or social media posts and blog posts and things like that.
So. Absolutely. And so a little bit more of the marketing opportunities. Lindsay Cope and I are marketing and event coordinator. Dynamic woman. Her and I are actually reviewing that in a prior chamber chat. I think it was our first chamber chat ever, actually.
Fantastic.
So you can kind of learn more a little bit about that through that chamber chat. We discussed why Beverly Hills Chamber, which basically comes down to her mission of empowering businesses to thrive by being an invaluable resource for optimizing connections through those three main things.
Yes.
So it's the government affairs and advocacy, the events and programs,
marketing.
And the sponsorship,
all that stuff.
And then the marketing and sponsorship. So again, all this will be broken down in the comments section below, just to give you that broader picture scope of things. But we really thank you for tuning in. We hope to see you at an upcoming event or program. But we would be absolutely remiss to not give you a few save the dates for those events and programs.
Absolutely. Number one tomorrow is, again, our Get to Know Your Chamber. So we did just kind of briefly touch on some of those main points that we will go over. But for more formal orientation, come visit us here at the boardroom tomorrow, 8 to 9:30, where we give you that total bird's eye view of everything that the chamber does offer. I guarantee you, whether you are a chamber member or you're a future chamber member, coming to that, learning what your benefits are, have us give you the checklist of benefits that go with your membership and take advantage of every single thing that we offer, because you will be successful if you do that.
Absolutely. So that again is tomorrow morning here at the Chamber. And then August 6th, we have a Business Needs to Know, Dominating Your Local Market Online. So our Business Needs to Know seminars. Yeah, no, they're really good. We work with the Small Business Development Center and have a professional from there speak to the audience about that. A lot of them are on marketing topics, which we typically see a great audience at. So not only are the Business Needs to Know seminars great just to come and learn about the topic, but also a little bit of networking as well.
And interrupt along those points. I notice with my members, our members, I get a little territorial. I love my members. But I notice with the ones that seem to find more success through the chamber, they're the ones that are attending these events, the educational programs. So if you're a small business and really looking to help your business thrive, these are the tools that are absolutely necessary for you to, you know, help boost your business savvy a little bit.
Absolutely. So, no, that's a really good point to make.
Yeah.
So the next one,
and I did mention it already, but it's worth noting again, is our Economic Development Council luncheon. It is on August 8th, and it is a luncheon with Stan Kasten. So if you're interested in learning more about joining EDC, please reach out to me. I'm happy to help out. But with your membership, you will have 2 tickets, and you can go have lunch with Stan.
I love that. Oh, the first name basis. Here we are.
Yeah. He doesn't know that yet.
Yeah, no, I love that.
I'm excited.
And then we did also mention this prior, but the Government Affairs Committee meeting, that is going to be August 8th here at the Chamber in the boardroom, complimentary for members, and this is where you can get your voice heard if you are a business within our community, because a lot of those things that we had mentioned before will probably impact your business, if not now, but maybe down the road.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then we also have the August networking breakfast.
Oh, absolutely. So we have at the Palm Restaurant in Beverly Hills. So you're looking at August 9th. Our networking breakfasts are typically the second Friday of every month. And we've had a little change recently. Our breakfasts have become so popular, which is a great thing.
Yes.
But, you know, we do have to remember why we're here. And we are a membership organization for our businesses in the community. So those that join the chamber and are members of the chamber, we're going to do everything we can to help you network with all the right people. So because of the popularity of the event, we have chosen to make the networking breakfast a member-only event going forward. So
okay.
I think it's you know, it's the right thing to do for our member businesses. And
the
if
right
you're
time.
Interested, yeah, absolutely. If you're interested in being a part of that, you know, the great thing, and I know that you all went over this with Nick and your regular networking events, but the opportunity to be able to stand up and give, you know, your elevator pitch to a captive audience of upwards of 100 business men and women in the community, that's a huge value. And so definitely come and take advantage of that. It's August 9th at the Palm, 8 to 9:30.
Love that. So that's just, we have a lot of stuff going on next week, don't we?
So
we always
week.
Do. It's a great week.
I love that.
And then last but not least, as far as the next couple of weeks are concerned, on August 14th, we have a health talk. Everything you need to know about dietary supplements, that'll be from 12 to 1 o'clock.
That's good.
Yep, here.
That's important.
Oh, absolutely. And that'll be here in the boardroom.
Yeah.
Our health talks are curated by our Health and Wellness Committee, which we do have a chamber chat about that as well. So that'll be really a great one to attend. And
absolutely.
Again, as Michelle said prior, it's not always just about the topic,
exactly.
But it's a great networking opportunity.
Right?
I love that. It's a great networking opportunity as well. So that again is August 14th from 12 to 1 o'clock here in the boardroom. And just a reminder, all of these things are going to be outlined in the comments below. If you have any questions, our contact information will be there as well. And we thank you for tuning in today and listening to
Michelle.
Thank
you so much. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely.
This was a lot of fun. And I love working with this lady. So thank
you.
I appreciate
it. I love working with you too.
So, and we have fun. One of our core values.
Number 6 core value. Have fun. But thanks again for tuning in, everyone. And we look forward to seeing you soon.
Bye.